In the middle of this economic crisis, there's one triad town that's considering a proposal that is rubbing some of their residents the wrong way. Kim Gebbia joins us now with that story. Kim?
Parked in Pilot Mountain city limits ever again. Commissioners made the bold move to ban them from the two remaining areas they were allowed. And some residents say limiting any type of low-income housing in this economy is simply poor timing. Pilot Mountain is on a 20-year improvement plan.
We're trying to create a certain type of walkable community that will hold home values.
But one thing that plan doesn't include for this quaint mountain town: mobile homes. The town commissioners unanimously voted to ban all new mobile homes from Pilot Mountain. Homes like Jose Francis. Although this trailer and the dozen or so others in town will be grandfathered in, the law does not allow owners to replace their existing trailer. People like France must either buy a house or move out of town.
I think it can be detrimental to the community. I mean, with the economy the way it is right now and the unemployment rate constantly going up, there are no jobs. So it's more self-sufficient as far as home ownership. Cost of living is a lot higher now, so it's harder on the families.
Town manager Blair Knox says the timing may be tough, but he says getting rid of homes like these is in everyone's best interest.
It was much more about quality of life issues and how they want the future of their town to look.
I think it's a good idea to ban mobile homes in the city limits.
Jerry Reed lives on Davis Street, one of the roads with a small cluster of mobile homes. He agrees with the ban and says trailers can be an eyesore in the community.
It's the aesthetics that has a lot to do with it. I think if you take care of your mobile home and you keep it up, that's fine, but I think a lot of them are not.
And for France, he says banning mobile homes is weeding out low-income families, where purchasing a house is simply not a viable option.
You get one $10,000, $20,000, $30,000. You take a home nowadays, it's $100,000 or better. Where can you get the money from if you don't have the income coming in?
Now, as time goes on and people begin to move out of those homes, Knox says they will most likely be replaced with housing developments that fit into the new zoning laws. But there is one exception. If there is an emergency or something like a house fire where a trailer is temporarily needed, those will, in fact, be allowed. Cameron, back to you. All right.